Hello.
Good evening, students. Hope you are doing good. Yeah, it's very boring and we had spent so much time in our home. Hope we can pray to change all this condition and we might have to enjoy more freedom. Okay, then let's start. Today we are going to discuss about an important topic frequently asked in all exams. It is based on environment education. Environment education is a major topic in all exams, NET, CTET, SET, KTET, all other exams, BSc, UPSC exam. So today we are going to discuss about renewable and non-renewable resources. Shall we start? Okay. Natural resources are divided into renewable and non-renewable resources. Natural resource can be divided into two types, renewable and non-renewable. Then we are going to discuss about what is renewable and non-renewable. A renewable resource is a resource which is replaced naturally and can be used again. A resource that can be developed naturally and can be used again and again and doesn't exit completely from our earth, which it produced according to the usage, is known as a renewable resource. Example: solar energy, wind, wood fiber, etc. are examples. Then non-renewable resources. Non-renewable resources are irreplaceable because it takes millions of years for nature to regenerate them. Non-renewable resources are irreplaceable. They cannot be produced according to their usage. It will diminishing or decreasing according to our usage. For example, coal, oil and minerals are examples of non-renewable resources. So renewable resources can be replaced and created naturally, but non-renewable resources cannot replace naturally. It will reduce according to its usage. Okay. When we discuss about which are the major renewable resources. First one, forest. A forest is a very large area of land covered by tall trees and undergrowth comprising wild flora and fauna. While a forest is a very large area of land covered by tall trees and undergrowth comprising flora and fauna. What is flora and fauna? Fauna refers to wide variety of animals and flora refers to wide variety of plants and fauna refers to wide variety of animal species. In India, 24.01% of land is covered by forest. In India, about 24.01% of land is covered by forest. The next importance of forest. The first renewable resource is forest, and then discuss about which are the importance forest. Forest, the prominence of forest. Forest provide many opportunity for scientific and medical discoveries and economic developments. They help to face challenges of pollution, water scarcity, global warming. Forest have great opportunity for scientific, for medical discovery and medical and also economic development. They help to face the consequence of pollution, water scarcity and also control global warming. Forest can clean up the atmosphere by absorbing carbon dioxide. Forest can the capability to clean our atmosphere by releasing oxygen and absorbing carbon dioxide. Forest is the largest producer of many varieties of flowers, fruits, timber and medicinal plant. If managed in an eco-friendly manner, forests can be developed for recreation and tourism. Can be also used for recreation and tourism. Next is function of forest. Function of forest includes sustenance of environmental protection, serving as storehouse of wood, non-wood produce, providing livelihood to people, etc. Function include, it is a storehouse of wood and non-wood produce. It is a major livelihood for many people, especially tribal people living. For them, it is a livelihood for them. Then, C. Overexploitation of forest. Overexploitation of forest has led to deforestation. This led to depletion of forest resource and environment damage. Overexploitation of forest is quite common nowadays. When it is reduced or affected or destroyed for large amount, the result is deforestation. And deforestation is the reason for many major climatic changes, and it also led to the reduce or depletion of forest resource and also environment damage. C. Consequence of deforestation, after effects of deforestation. It will result in loss of biodiversity, it will reduces the many species, and also there is disruption of water cycle also affect the rainfall. There will shortage of rain. They will create famine, also create drought, increasing soil erosion are other major consequences of deforestation. Second, food resources. Human food come from agriculture, animal husbandry and fishing. Human food came from three aspects. From animal husbandry, agriculture and fishing. Production of human food ultimately tap natural resource. And so food resource come under natural resource. Food problems in the world. Developed nation consume 80% of world food production. But in developing nation, 40% doesn't have enough nutrition food. Developed nation, about 80% of people have enough food. But in developing nation, more than 40% didn't have enough nutrition food. They are starving. Technology used to increase agriculture production create many environment and economic issues. Food resources are diminishing because of non-sustainable utilization. Food resources are diminishing nowadays because of over-exploitation of nature. Then, changes caused by agriculture and overgrazing. Modern agriculture technology creates impoverishment of soil, poisoning environment and degradation of water quality. Overgrazing also leads to reduction of vegetation, reduction in species, diversity, increase in soil erosion, etc. Then, see, effect of modern agriculture. In modern agriculture, chemical fertilizers and pesticides are used increasingly. And this use of chemical and pesticide also reduced agriculture. They led to genetic diversity loss and environment degradation. Long-term food security require conserving wild variety of crop plant. A second green revolution is necessary in order to provide food for all and to restrict the use of these chemical fertilizers and pesticides. Then, non-renewable resources. Non-renewable resources. One, water resource. Water is a key natural resource responsible for life on Earth. Total mass of water on Earth constant over time. Water exists in three forms. We know this. Solid, liquid and gas. Water cycle means continuous movement of water above and below the surface of Earth. Then, the next class, we will come with another topic and we will detail about non-renewable resources and is now enough. Hope you enjoyed it. Stay safe, study well. Goodbye.